I'm gonna go to. Yeah, we're just gonna do a new game. And I play on hard. I play on fucking hard. But before we do that, let me just grab some water. Alright? Let me grab some water and I'll be right back. And, yeah, you talk about Digimon World. Like, I streamed that and, like, it bored everyone to tears. Like, I literally just. I chased everyone out of there. Like, people couldn't get out of my channel fast enough. Digimon World, like, it just kills. It just kills everyone's enthusiasm, and it'll make you go to sleep. So, refilling on my water, or maybe some cola, not sure. Got my water. I'm all good to go. And I got like the worst sodas. Like, okay, here's the thing, right? So in my fridge, I got a whole big thing of Dr. Bob. Now, I know what you're thinking, like Dr. Bob. What's that, right? Well, Dr. Bob is basically, it's like the poor man's, it's like the poor man's Dr. Perky, which is the broke man's Dr. Pepper. So, like, if you want to know what Dr. Bob tastes like, it tastes like the most watered down Dr. Pepper you've ever had, with absolutely no flavor at all. It's a generic brand, but that's what you get, right? That's what you get when you go generic. Okay, so Dead Space. Man, okay, here's the thing, right? Like, you all know how much I I'm always pestering people about, the Void, about like my space horror tabletop and all that. Well, the thing is, Dead Space is the game that really got me into like that whole, hard sci-fi space horror thing. It's like what got me into that. And and Dead Space is a lot like, well, it's a lot like, every movie that you've ever seen about, space madness and alien creatures and things like that. It's all of that wrapped into one video game, and I love it. But yeah, so I started this up, before I get into it, I just want to state this, right? I started the game before, but no one was watching. And that doesn't stop me from playing games, right? Like, I will play games even when no one's watching. But the thing is that when it comes to, like, story-based games, if no one's watching, then, it gets in the way, right? It gets in the way. You want people to see things from beginning to end, you don't want to just, roll things on when no one's there, so. Alright. Shall we do it? Shall we do it? Let's just get right in there. So here's the fun thing about this game's brightness, right? The fun thing about this game's brightness is that, like, I don't see anything right now. Like, I don't see anything, and if I go all the way over to the right, I don't see anything. Like, I don't see anything. So I'm just gonna keep the brightness, like, right here, like, right there. I'm gonna keep the brightness right there. Because, like, when I slide the slider all the way over to the right, I don't see shit. And you know what? Like, the thing is, this game is supposed to be dark, so I'm gonna leave it how it is. So, yeah. Let's do it. I don't have any downloadable content. EA is always trying to sell you some kind of DLC nonsense. I don't have any of that. So, let's get into it. Let's just jump right in. And hopefully I'll do better this time. Like, hopefully I won't suck quite as bad this time around. Like, hopefully I'll manage my resources a little bit better. So this is a good opportunity for me. And this is also one of very few EA games that doesn't, like, just doesn't completely suck. It's actually, like, unique and original.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. It's strange. Such a little thing.
How many times you watched that thing? Guess you really miss her. Don't worry, we're almost there. You'll be able to look her up once we're on board. Sounds like you do.
I'll try to stay quiet during the talkie parts. This game doesn't have that many talkie parts, so I'll be quiet when they have.
All this trouble over that chunk of rock.
Deep space mining is a lucrative business, Ms. Daniels. Aegis 7 is a gold mine, according to Prospector's reports. Cobalt, silicon, osmium. Now, where is she? There she is. We have visual contact.
So that's Ishimura. Impressive.
The USG Ishimura. Biggest planet cracker in her class. And it looks like they already popped the cork.
Why is it all dark? I don't see any running lights.
Corporal, take us in closer and hail them. And stay clear of that debris field. We're here to fix their ship, not the other way around.
USG Ishimura, this is the emergency maintenance team of the USG Kellyan responding to your distress call. Come in, Ishimura.
You're gonna need to boost the signal if our power's low.
Yes, we know. Boost the signal. More.
Never heard of a total communications blackout on one of these things. You'd think with 1,000 people on board, someone would pick up the phone.
What is that?
It's a busted array like we thought. Sounds like they're having problems with their encoder. You get us down there and Isaac and I can fix it. 48 hours max.
All right, you have the lady. Take us in, let's see what needs fixing.
Gravity tethers engaged. Automatic docking procedures a go.
What the hell?
Sir, the auto dock.
What is it?
We're off track, we're gonna hit the hull.
Hit the blast shields. That guidance tether's damaged. Switch to manual, now.
Inside the magnetic field? Are you insane? Abort!
No, we can make it inside. Corporal, I gave you an order.
I love this intro. I really do love that intro. It really does set the tone for what you're playing. Also, don't all go quiet on me now.
What? What the hell were you thinking? Were you trying to get us killed?
I just saved our asses, Ms. Daniels. If we had aborted at that speed and distance, we'd have smashed right into the side of the Ishimura. Now settle down, let's get to work. Corporal, report.
I'm not getting any readings from the port booster, and we've lost comms and autopilot. It'll take some time to fix.
All right, let's get some extra hands from flight deck to help out.
Hold still, Isaac. I'm syncing up everyone's rig with the ship. Okay, we're done. Clean bill of health for everyone.
All right, we've still got a job to do. We're moving out.
Look at those two guys with their mustaches. Like mustache and other guy. Yeah, you know they're gonna last long, right? Okay, so I actually have control now. Actual gameplay, right? Look at this. This is one of the few games. I'm gonna repeat a few things I said last time, but you know they deserve saying. Okay, so look, you have this little thing, and this tells you where to go. I usually don't like that. I usually really don't like that kind of thing in my games, but you know what? It works here, right? Like it works. And also, no L3 to run. It's L2 plus L. You know, yes, L2 plus move. So look at this. See, look. Yeah, there you go. Small med pack right there. Yeah, just, you know, here's the thing, right? You gotta look around. You gotta look around everything in this game. Because, like, there's little things, right? Like, there's little things to find everywhere. So, you know, like, if I rub around on everything, it's like, that's what.
You didn't lose power to the port booster. You lost the port booster. Unbelievable.
So, yeah, we're not leaving in that ship. Yeah, definitely not leaving in that.
With 62 years of continuous service, it holds the record for highest number of planet cracks, with 34 to date, and highest dead weight of refined product at 14 trillion kilotons and counting.
Guess the power's down everywhere. Isaac, get over here and hack the door pad.
Also, do tell me, does it look way too dark on you all's end? It's a little hard to tell on my end. Like, it's a little hard to tell if it's too dark or not. I don't want it to be too bright, though, because this is, like, you know, it is a space horror game, and it, you know, it is meant to be dark. You know, like, the dark parts are meant to be dark, and, like, the well-lit rooms like this are meant to be well-lit. So, like, if it looks dark right now, then I'll tone it up a little bit. And I'm just gonna grab all the items I can.
Seems like everyone is trying to pack in a hurry.
Look at this guy.
There should be a security detail.
Look at this generic man right here.
Yeah? Well, there's not. There's nobody here. I can't pick up any broadcasts.
Okay, so again, you know, especially when you play on hard mode, right?
Isaac, log in.
Like, especially when you play on the hard difficulty, you really, really want to, like, you really want to find every item you can possibly find.
The damn power.
Okay, I'm just gonna get right into it.
We all cooperate. We can figure this out a lot sooner. Let's get that computer display up, Isaac.
So, yeah, see, like, everyone's behind the glass there.
Yeah,
there we go. Telling me to use the locator system. Nice. I do have a map, too. Yeah, see, if I hit select, get, like, a nice little 3D map. It's one of the things, this is one of the other things I really like about this game, too, right? Yeah, see, like, the interface in this game is all, like, it's all, like, part of, you know, it's, like, part of your weird sci-fi technology, you know, your inventory and all that. It's all, like, actually, you know, part of your in-game heads up. So, okay. So when I hit this button, I guess when I hit this button, all I'll say is I hope you weren't too attached to Mr. Mustache and his friend. I hope you weren't too attached to these totally plot essential characters that aren't, you know, they aren't just here just to get killed. I hope you weren't too attached. I'm just gonna go stand over here right now. I'm just gonna stand next to this door for no particular reason.
System's offline. Getting around is gonna be difficult. Air seems to be flung again. That's a start.
What the hell was that?
Automatic quarantine must have tripped.
Yeah, as soon as I can, I want to move towards that door right there.
What was that? Did you hear that?
Not sure.
What the hell? I don't know. Something's in the room with us.
Oh yeah, look. Yeah, there's your alien. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Come on.
I'm not even gonna look at it, because I know it's coming. I know it's coming. Yep, time to get the fuck out of here. Time to get out of here. Time to get the fuck out of here. Like, right now. There is actually no time. I gotta move. Come on, come on. Okay, we're good. Where are we? No, we're good. So, yeah. See, I did that very nicely. Didn't take any damage whatsoever. It's... Like, okay, here's the thing. You can absolutely die in that section. Like, I mean, this... You know, here's the thing, right? Like, a lot of games, they'll give you, like, you know, fake tension, right? Like, I mean, I know how modern games do, okay? Like, a lot of modern games, you know, they'll put you, like, in a seemingly tense situation, but, like, it's all fake, right? You know, like, it's just a scripted sequence, and it's, you're never in any real danger, or it's just, like, a quick time thing, or no. See, in this game, like, if you, you know, like, in that whole section I was just in, like, if you, you know, if you wait around, right, like, if you don't run fast enough, or, like, you just stand there watching, like, no, you will die. Like, you will get hit, and you will get killed before the game even really starts. Okay, like, it's that kind of game. That looks nice. Also, like, let me just see. I'm just looking over on my other monitor real quick. I think I want to up the brightness just a little bit. Just a little bit. Yeah, it doesn't really do a whole lot, but... Yeah, I just want to make sure people can actually see what's going on. Again, you know, man, like, everyone got, like, you all got, like, so quiet the moment I switched games. Like, you know, speak up, man. Speak up. If it's too dark, speak up. So, here we go. This is the fun part of this game, is it's all about chopping off the limbs. See, look, cut off the limbs. Yep, I got a punch and a stomp. And, you know, like, look at that. Ooh. Got all the fun stuff. Okay, got some credits and some other stuff. We're making out good. The loot is a little bit random. Just a little bit. So, I'm gonna break these open. There's my ammo. What's over here? I know you hear that guy, like, you know, screaming, and he's fine. He's fine for right now. So I have a light here. You know, unfortunately, like, very unfortunately, this is that kind of light where it's, yeah, see, it's just like it's a very specific point light. So, here's what I do, right? Break that open. And, okay, I'm just gonna switch this around, and let's get ready. So, yeah, you gotta shoot the limbs on these things, these necromorphs here. You gotta shoot their limbs. You know, headshots don't really do it, and body shots do next to nothing. So, yeah, that guy's, he's nice and dead. Doesn't have anything on him, he's just dead. So I'm gonna keep my peace out here. Because I'm always paranoid. Come down here. Oh! There's a spook down there. Yeah, I know all about health packs. I don't need help with that. Thanks. How's my inventory looking? I got lots of health packs, some ammo.
This is Benson. Everybody listen up. They use the vents. That's how they're getting around the ship. Stay away from down! Get back! Get back!
So, yeah, I love it. I love it when people, you know, they take the time to record an audio log right before they die. Or while they're dying. I mean, it's so nice of them. It really is.
Isaac, we ran into more of them on the way over here. Are you okay?
More what? What the hell are those things? Is that the crew?
Keep your voice down. Whatever they are, they're not friendly, and half the doors on this ship are locked because of the quarantine. Now, we have to get to the bridge, but first, we gotta repair the tram system.
You're crazy, Hammond. You're gonna get us all killed.
If you listen to me, I will get you out of here alive. Now, what's wrong with the tram?
the data board is fried, but there should be a spare in the maintenance bay. There's also a broken tram blocking the tunnel that needs to be repaired. Damn it! Everything is on the other side of this quarantine. We can't reach it from here.
No, we can't. But you can. Isaac, if I can get to the bridge, I should be able to access the personnel files. You fix the tram, and I'll help you find Nicole.
All right. We have an objective now. So, yeah, we can use the map to check where we need to go, but, like, it doesn't really matter. All that matters is that you follow the little blue line, which, you know what, I'm actually kind of thankful that there's a blue line to follow. I gotta break everything. I gotta do it. Alright, so we do have us an objective to perform. We need to get some things so that we can call the train here, so that they can get out of here, and so that, you know, ultimately we can get out of here as well. So what do we got? We got a med pack, and some of that plasma cutter energy. It's all good. Let's save that game. Save it good. So, yeah, you can see here, like, I got to Chapter 2 last time. But, you know what? I'm doing a lot better. Like, I'm actually doing a lot better this time. Like, so far, anyway. I haven't taken any damage yet, so I'm already ahead of myself. Alright, we gotta go to the right. But I think there's something to the left. I think there's something down that hallway. And you know I gotta do it, right? You know I gotta do it. Like, I know you just saw that, right? And I saw that plasma energy. Yeah, so see, he is gonna get up. Oh, you know he's gonna get up. You know that motherfucker's gonna get up. But I think he's just playing pretend right now. Like, I hate to turn my back on him. But I think he'll stay there if I just go this way. Oh, there's a spook! Goddamn spooks, alright? That's the thing, there's a couple cheap scares like that,
Isaac,
that it's like,
be careful.
You don't serve a
shooting
purpose,
them in the body,
but they're very
work.
Rare.
Go for the limbs, dismember them. That should do the job.
Yep, I know all about cutting things up. Yep, thank you. Thank you for that. I know all about chopping things up. Know all about it. Got some money. Anything else over here? No, where am I? Okay, so this is the train. This is like where the train goes. So, yeah, let's just keep moving here. Stasis module. Very important.
Looks like that door is malfunctioning, Isaac. Try using the stasis module you just picked up.
Okay, so this is real handy here. See, normally you just get chopped up by this thing, but let me reload and where am I? Okay. Which way do I need to go? I need to go that way, right? I haven't really done anything, so I don't really need to use the save station. But, anything over here? There's a little item right here. Let me just get that item, and, it is so dark I can't see anything. I can literally not see anything. Okay, we're good. It's all good. all good.
Your stasis module should be able to help you with that arm mechanism.
Okay, what's over here? A power node. That's useful. So, okay, this room is gonna get a little hectic. It's gonna get just a little bit hectic kinda soon, so... before I do anything, I'm just gonna clear all the items in the room. Make sure I'm good, you know, good for health, I'm good for ammo, good for everything. Now, we wanna make use of stasis here, because it's like there's a stasis charge right there. Well, some dead bodies, always a good sign in dead space.
Get it back to the repair depot, but now the autoloader is fried. I need a stasis module brought down here now. If we don't get this piece of shit off the tracks, it's gonna jam up the whole system.
Alright, fun times. So, let me just, stomp them good. Okay, so I'm pretty sure there's gonna be some more stuff that's gonna jump me, so I'm just gonna try to make it attack me, if I can. Okay, they don't want to come out just yet. Took a hit too. I hate taking a hit. Let's just fix that. You know what? I actually have too many items, so like, that was a good thing. That was a good thing I took a hit there. Okay, there we go. So now, refill my stasis, and here we go. All good to go. Can we get the hell out of here?
Please stand by.
Can we get the hell out of here?
Isaac, you did it. The tram is blocking the whole system. When you get the computer online, you'll be able to call the tram from the control room. Faster the better. I can hear something crawling around out there.
Okay, that's nice. Can we leave now? Can we leave now? Of course. I'm always expecting something to jump out at me from behind. I don't think that could work. No, I think that's just a distraction. Yeah, that's just a distraction. Okay. Let's go the other way now. Maybe my aim is a little off, so it's a cold controller. Yeah, either way, I think I'm doing okay for ammo. Yeah, got plenty of ammo. And just refill stasis. Set up. Yeah, okay, good. You know, could have handled that a little better. Could have handled it a little better, but,
Isaac, I've patched into the deck security system. It took some work, but I've got the door to the maintenance bay unlocked. The data board should be somewhere inside.
Okay. So I really gotta get better at aiming the stasis, like, I just seem to have a lot of issue with aiming that thing. So this guy is gonna pop up. Like, I know he's gonna pop up, you know he's gonna pop up, we all know he's gonna pop up. So let's just, let's get in there and stomp him, stomp his ass in right now. Yeah, see that's one good thing about stasis, right? You know, is that if you make good proper use of your stasis, like, yeah, you can just kill enemies like that. The ones that are just sitting around.
This is Benson, Tram Engineering. We think we figured it out. Smith killed one. Listen, forget about shooting him in the body. You gotta cut off the limbs. Grab a cutter, anything like that. Cut him apart.
Yeah, they really have to. Okay, so here's the thing, right? There's a lot of repeat audio logs and things like that. Tutorial type of stuff.
I still need to find the data board to the tram computer. It's in the maintenance bay.
Yeah, I know. But it's like, the thing is, EA basically, you know, it's where they stepped in and they figured that people are going to be too stupid to, you know, the kids aren't going to understand this whole dead space, you know, so they figured they'd have to tutorialize everything like 5 times.
Isaac, it's Kendra. It looks like the door to the storage room is locked. There should be a key somewhere in the maintenance bay.
Alrighty, so... something. I hear something. Yep. Yeah, I hear it. I see it. Yeah, they can move really fast when they want to. Yeah, I don't have the ammo for this right now. Okay, let me just get rid of one of these. How's my ammo again? Yeah, I'm a little low on ammo. Like, I'm doing pretty good for health, but ammo is... Like, if I have the option of freezing some of them and taking them out like that, probably what I should do. Basically, you know, I try to make use of the environmental stuff as much as I can. So, okay, how are we for space? I have no inventory space at all. I have to use something. So, yeah, I'll just use one of my little med packs. Like, see, that's the thing. Like, I'm actually doing a little too well. I have too much space on my hands. Oh, goddamn. Goddamn. Look at this! This is nonsense, right? There we go. Power stomp. Okay. Damn, it always sounds like there's something behind me. I hate this room. Like, I really do hate this room because it always feels like there's something, like there's noises. You know, there's noises happening, and it's dark. You know, there's lots of dark corners, there's noises happening, and it always feels like something is right behind me. Okay, look, see, I have no inventory space, so I have to use up something. Yeah, see, I have to use... Yeah, you know, gotta use up that health item. Okay, I think I'll have to go that way later. Okay, let's just go up. Okay, so that guy is definitely not dead. He is really not dead. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I'm just gonna stomp his legs off. Yeah, just stomp his legs off. Stomp his face off. Repair invoice, I don't need to look at that. So here's the item I need, but I also need to pick up that other thing, too. Okay, look, I gotta use some items here. Space. Okay, I'm doing good. I got space. I got some space. That's good. Let's keep moving. And as usual, I back up and, like, I'm always ready for something to jump out at. Yeah, see? Like, I'm always ready for that to happen. Get moving here. Okay. Just get in there. Like, I am so goddamn ready for something to just jump out, you know, jump out of nowhere at me. Oh man, so many items, I can't carry them all. And spooky noises just everywhere. Okay, so yeah, workbench. That's good stuff. I just need a moment here. Just need a moment, you know. Okay, workbench. So I have two nodes, right? Nodes. Well, I can upgrade two things. Damage. Damage is very important. You want damage. Yeah, the rig, you know, air is nice, but it's ultimately not, like, it's not essential. I'm gonna just hold on to my power node. You always want to have one power node just for, just in case you come across a locked door, basically.
That's it, Isaac. Take the board back to tram control and slot it into the computer array. That should get the transmitter.
No time for talking, woman. No time. I knew it. I knew there'd be one right fucking behind me. Yeah, ain't no time for talking. Yeah, okay, let's just, let us move ass out of here. Oh crap, I didn't see that one. Again, it's kind of a good thing, because guess what? I got too much inventory, so, you know. Man, I still got had by that guy. Got had by him. But yeah, see, here's the thing, right? Like, in Dead Space, it's like, just expect for things to jump out at you from the elevators. And also, look, you get a nice view of, like, what the Necromorphs are here. Because they never really explicitly explain, like, what they are in the first game. But, like, look at that. It's like, you know, it's like a dude with a, like, his stomach is open and there's just, like, extra limbs coming out of his stomach. And then, you know, got the knife hands. Yeah, you see, you got the knife hands, and just like all kinds of fucked up. But yeah, that's Necromorphs for you. You know, they're basically just, you know, dead bodies with all kinds of special attachments. Fun times. Alright, gonna save. Well, actually, you know what? I don't need to save. Because there's another section coming up soon, so yeah, we're good for now. Let's just get the hell out of here. Let us just get the hell out. And again, I'm always ready. Always ready for something to jump at me. Alright.
Fan control computer now online. Shipwide tram system reinitialized. All trams
right,
now operational.
The trams are going.
Tram arriving at flight deck station. Quarantine lifted.
Alright, we can get out of here now. You know, they're
on
board.
Their
way to
the bridge. Good work.
Strange. The quarantine just lifted.
Whatever was in the flight lounge must have left. That's lucky for us. Isaac, get back to the Kellion and prep it for launch. We'll find out what we can from the bridge and meet you there.
If we live that long. You're out of your league, Hammond. This is suicide. We're going
your
to die out here.
Your lack of confidence in me is duly noted, Miss Daniels. But I have a mission to complete, and that's exactly what I am going to do, with or without you. Do we understand each other?
Just get us out of here alive.
Okay, so we got a new objective. Yeah, we gotta launch our ship and, you know, get out of here. Of course, nothing will go wrong. Nothing will ever go wrong. Also, yeah, that dead body's gone. The dead body's fucking gone. Where's it gone to? Best not to ask questions about that kind of thing. Best not to ask questions about that kind of thing. That guy's still dead, though. So, yeah, just stay dead. So, okay, right now we're going back up to where we were at the start of the game. You know, we're taking the elevator and going right back. But I'm gonna try to get the jump on him. Come on, I'm just gonna get the jump on you. Of course! It sounded like there was something behind me, but there wasn't. That paranoia, right? Okay. Reloading again. How are we for ammo, anyway? Yeah, I'm a little low on ammo. I have lots of health items, lots of that, but I'm kind of low on ammo. Again, just be ready for something to pop through that door and just take me out. I'm always ready for it. Alright, nice. We're back at the flight lounge. You know, where we first started this game off.
Isaac, we made it to the bridge. It's a nightmare up here. No survivors. We're going to try to get to the command computer. Wish us luck.
Yep, so as per usual, no survivors. So we want to go that way. Anything else here? Anything else? Anything else at all? Doesn't look like it, really. So, yeah, let's go out there. Oh, I see you. I see you. Yeah, so, gotta get all my items first, you know? No items left behind. Some energy, probably gonna need it, so let's get a move on. Okay, anything over here before I go in the ship, you know? So again, this is our trusty ship here. It's completely trashed. Just, you know, checking to make sure there's nothing, you know, we haven't left anything behind. So yeah, here's where we start the game, but, Yeah, we gotta get out of there. Gotta get out of there. Yeah, so we're not leaving on that. We're really not leaving on that. And we got friends now.
happened to the shuttle?
That was our ride home. It's the only way off the ship.
Kendra.
No, Hammond! This changes everything!
Just let me think. Can you access the command computer?
It's no good. There's an executive lockdown of all primary systems. Without the captain's authorization, I can't access them.
Well, where's the captain?
Here he is. Captain Benjamin Mathias. Location? Med lab. Status? Deceased.
What? How?
I can't access that information. Find the captain and you'll find his rig. With his authorization codes, I can crack this computer wide open.
Damn it. Isaac, I'm sending the tram back to your location. Get to the medical deck and find that rig as fast as you can.
What was that?
It's like everyone's having a little bit of problems. Okay, so this is the other fun little mechanic of this game. There's a store. So before I do that, let me just look around here real quick. There's always Peng. So is there anything I can find around here? Nope. So yeah, we were on those tracks earlier. Yeah, like we were on those tracks a little while earlier, but yeah, now the train's here and we're ready to leave this chapter. But not before we do a little shopping. Okay, so see, look, I got all these med packs. Here's the cool thing, right? Like, you can move all these med packs. You can move them over. Yeah, see, you can move them. Yeah, you can move all the med packs over to your safe, and then you can pick them up later, which is, of course, very useful. So what do I want here? Well, I want the level 2 suit. It gives an increase to inventory and armor. You know, that's what I want, so I'll buy that. So, we just mosey on into our Mega Man upgrade chamber, right here. And then we come out with a nice little upgraded suit. You know, because engineering, you need that for the engineering. Okay, so I got 7,200 credits still. I could buy more ammo, but I don't really think that's I don't really need it yet. And there's other things I want to spend that money on. So if I look at my if I look at my rig now, I have a lot more space now. So I'm not at risk of running out like I was. I am a little low on ammo though. I will totally admit that I am a little bit low on ammo, but I'm willing to wait it out. Okay, well, we are done with chapter 1. So, let's get on out of here.